Primates are legal. Chimpanzees, baboons, monkeys. And you see many people, mainly Star Wars, going out buying pet monkeys. Oh, he's so cute, he's so cuddly. But that same cute and cuddly monkey can be very dangerous. It will rip your face off, it will tear you apart. You gotta look at those monkeys like sin, like a dog drinking. Amen? It seems so cute and cuddly when you're out there doing it. You'll start ripping away at your flesh, amen? Turn your family apart, amen? Turn your home apart, turn your church apart. What's happening in your home and then spilling over into the church, amen? And it's turning the church apart, amen? It's too much division, and God has got to offer confusion. So when you see and you know what God has for you, that little cute monkey, that little cute chimpanzee that you want to buy as a pet to carry around with you, you decide to leave them in the store because it's not working, amen? Y'all ain't understand. Just because it's look cute and you think it's cute and it's good for you, amen? But you gotta know what you're looking at, amen? Because it's all dressed up on the outside and looking good on you, and it's for you. Well, God has something better for you. Amen. Also, while we're in the wilderness, there will be reptiles. These reptiles are the alligators, the tortoise, and the water turtle, which is a snake. The snakes by nature, they are vile, creepy animals. They're very sneaky. Amen. In Genesis, it was a snake that came up to Eve and convinced her to eat from the tree of good. That same snake that convinced Eve was still his way to your life to convince you to do things that goes against what pastors teaching and preaching, goes against what the Bible is saying, and have you out here doing what you want to do, thinking that you're in the right. But you got to learn to know, to recognize what that snake is in your life, whether it be your friends, your job. Sometimes they even be your spouse. You married the wrong person. You didn't marry who God had you married, thinking you can change them once you get into your marriage. But that person doesn't want to change. They want to do just what they want to do. They want to use you up like a cigarette. They smoke you up, stump on you, and just smash you out. Amen. It could be drugs, it could be alcohol, it could be what it may. That snake is in your life. You got to learn to recognize what that snake is. Amen. Once you realize what that snake is in your life, and you learn how to fight that snake, we're going to get in the next few minutes how to fight that snake in your life so that you can come out victorious, amen? In the wilderness, you will also encounter wild and exotic birds. These birds are from peacocks, ostriches, canaries, all beautiful birds, right? But also we'll encounter the eagle. And in the scripture says we gotta be strong like eagles, amen. Yeah. We gotta be able to spread our wings and fly like the eagle flies. You see, I did some studying up on the eagle. And they know their keen eyesight. They can see up to 2 miles away. Amen. Most of us can see 5 feet in front of us. We see what we want to see. You gotta be like that vision of that eagle to be able to see what it is God has for you. Amen. And see, think about that eagle. He can see that same snake we just talked about from 2 miles away. Feet in air. He spreads his wings, which go 8 feet wide. Amen. And when he comes down, that snake is so confused, he don't know which wing to go out, the left wing or the right. He just sees the shallows. He don't know which way to go. Amen. So when he's trying to get that wing, guess what that old eagle does? He comes with those sharp talons and picks him up. Amen. When he takes him up out of his comfort zone. Therefore, that snake ain't got that same fighting. He ain't got the same flexibility in midair as he does on the ground. Therefore, he got to take your snake up out of his environment, put him on your level where God has you to be. Amen? So therefore, when he's pushing in front of him, there's nothing he can do. But you got your talents in him. God has his talents in him, and he's gripping him. And he's squeezing the life out of that snake. Amen? Don't let that snake squeeze the life out of you. You squeeze the life out of that snake, amen? And you see, I said, those old eagles, they get smarter. Every year they build their nest higher and higher and higher. That's how we got to be in Christ. We got to start going higher and higher and higher. You can't get in that comfort zone. See, if I stayed in my comfort zone, I wouldn't be up here preaching right now, amen? I'd be in the back of the church hiding out somewhere, amen?
Yes,
sir. But see, when I moved back home to Virginia, I was going to church. When I first started going to this church, I would do just that. I would go sit in the back of the church. I wouldn't say that. Ask any guest preachers in the house, I wouldn't say that because I was in my comfort zone. But one day, God reminded me, if you do not mean it from a man, I did not hear it from my father. And you see, you got no one to step out of your comfort zone. Amen?
Yes, sir.
And know what God has called you to be. You can't worry about the person you left is thinking or the person you provide is thinking. Just know who you are in Christ. Amen? Like I said, it's called a comfort zone for a reason. You got to step out of that comfort zone so God can grow you in what He will have you to be. Amen? Just give me about 5 more minutes and I'm going to be out your guys' way. I want my brother here to set this up for me. Amen? See, when we're talking about vision, the other week, my brother, Minister Burnell, preached a sermon, I'm making a change. And I'm starting with the man in the mirror. Now you see, I'm in the mirror, right? But sometimes you can be too close to your own situation to know what's really going on in that mirror. I mean, you look at good from your perspective. Sometimes you gotta learn to take a step back and see things the way God will see them. You gotta let God give you God's vision, let God start exposing things in your life, amen? Once He starts to expose the things in your life, you'll realize, hey, maybe some of the things I think I got right, I'm not all together like I say I'm all together. You messed up, amen? You're a little bit messed up, you're a little bit off in some way because you're too close to your situation to know what's really going on. So you got to let God clean you up, amen? And for those of y'all who are front, you can see this mirror is not the cleanest thing in the world, right? That's our life. It's not the cleanest thing. I did this on purpose. I could have cleaned up before I came here. I want y'all to see how God will take time when you call on the name of Jesus. And you boom. You call on that name of Jesus. You plead the blood of Jesus on your life. Amen. God will come in. He will blot out your transgressions. He will. The blood of Jesus will come into your life. He will start to blot out your transgressions. Amen. He will clean you up. He will take away the spirit in your life. He will make you whole again. He will wipe away your tears. Amen. But if you look, you can see there's still spots in your life and pains in your life in this mirror, amen? That's just God letting you know, hey, I still got you. You can't do this on your own, church. You have to go to God. You get God to get these spots out your life. If you look at the mirror around the edges, it's a little rough and rugged, right? Look at us around our edges. We're rough and rugged too. Like the song last week, that old rugged cross. God is here to clean us up. Take that sandpaper called love. And He starts to smooth that thing out and smooth it out for you. Those bumps and those bruises you once had in your life, they're gone. But you have to call on Jesus, people, church. You have to have that vision to know God's going to do something great in your life. Like Pastor said earlier, when you guys first got this building, it wasn't the best building in the world. But look at it now. Look where we are now. Look where we're going now. You got to see what God's going to do next in this church. Amen. You got to have faith to believe. God is going to do something great in your life. I'm going to share my testimony with you, and I'm going to have my seat. 2000, I had just ended my first marriage, and I was going through a somewhat of a ugly divorce. And the enemy had me believing I wasn't working. It was to the point I even got killing myself. I took Motrin 800 out of a whole bottle. I took half of that bottle and I finished it with a pint of whiskey. Because the enemy got inside my head to the point saying, I was no good, you never amounted to anything, you'll never be nothing. You're a horrible father, you're a horrible husband. Just kill yourself now. And I let him get inside my mind. Amen. But glory be to God. I'm standing here today. He did not take my life, but if I wanted to go, God knew the vision he had for me. To be here in 2015 preaching to you guys to encourage somebody else. Young people, no matter how hard school gets, know that God has a greater plan for you.
Yeah.
No matter how unfair your parents seem, know that God has a greater vision for you. He put them there for a reason. They've been through the things they've been through to teach you, amen. People in the workforce, no matter how hard that job gets, don't give up. Don't give in. Don't let the enemy have his way in your life. Don't let the enemy win. You follow them leading like Daniel did, start just praying out to God right there at your workstation, wherever you be at. And watch God start moving and doing great things in your life. Amen. I said, I shouldn't be here today, but I thank God that I am. It's no mistake that I'm here. We each have a purpose in life. When you get to, when you start seeking God's face, like I said earlier, you get in God's word, that divine word, that word that won't move you. It won't move, allow nothing to move you. No matter what comes your way, when those thoughts of suicide come at you, God will block those off from you. Amen. When the enemy tries to attack you from every side, like the song said, no weapon formed against me. God will be there. He will be your hand of protection. Amen.
Yeah.
He will keep you in that perfect peace. Just keep your mind stayed on him.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father, for what you're doing in my life right now, Father. You see, sometimes I'm riding down the road, I just cry. It should be tears of joy.
Yes,
knowing what God has for me in my future. It is here. I'm in a good place now, but this is a temporary place. I got to step out of that comfort zone so God will grow me like that old eagle higher and higher in what he's doing for me, amen? And not just doing for me, but doing for the church, through the church. Father God, for that, I said, thank you. So, when somebody asks you what you're looking at, see more than what's right there in front of you. Amen? See what God has for you down the road. That's the only way to know that, to get in his word, and talk with him, and commune with him, and be in one with him. Amen? Amen.